Right? So, what is the meaning of true positive? Can anyone tell me? True positive means
Means
actually the person was classified as authentic and it was predicted by the system as authentic. So, it is a correct classification. True negative is also correct classification where a non-authenticated person is not given access, right? So this main diagonal 400 and 500, they represent the correct classification. And this 100 and 200 represent the wrong classification. Okay? So that is error. So can you tell me what is the accuracy of this system? How to calculate the accuracy of the system? Number of correct classification divided by total number of samples. How many classifications are correct in this?
Sir, it's 400.
400 plus 300. 400 are correctly classified positive, 300 are correctly classified negative. Right? So,
Yes, sir.
negative is also correct classification if it is to be rejected and rejected by the system. So, 700 correct classification divided by total number of samples. So, total how many test samples are there in this summation of all these four? That is 1000. So what is the accuracy of this system?
0.7.
Yes, 0.7 or 70%. Right? So this is the accuracy. Same way, can you calculate what is the error of the system? Error is 30%. Yes or no? It is 100 minus accuracy, or you can calculate this way also 200 plus 100 divided by 1000. Right? So, these two we have seen in the previous lecture. Now, we will see some more measures, evaluation measures, which we can derive from this confusion matrix. First measure is known as precision. Okay? So, what is precision? Precision is TP divided by TP plus FP. Okay. So can you tell me what is the value of TP? True positive.
400, sir.
400. And what is the value of TP plus FP?
500.
500.
500. So what is the precision value? 80%. Yes or no? Okay.
Yes, sir.
And recall is another measure. Its formula is TP divided by TP plus FL. Okay. What is TP?
400.
And what is TP plus FL?
Hello, sir.
Yes or no, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Now what do you say?
Okay. So, TP and FP. So, in this table, where is TP and FP? First column, right? So, first column represents what? It represents that the system predicted positive. Okay? Means the system allowed access to this many users. So the first column indicates that predicted positive users means they were allowed access by the system. So total 500 users were allowed access by the system, but out of those 500, only 400 were actual authentic users, right? Means out of 500, 400 users were to be given access, but 100 users have wrongly given access. Okay, so precision means what? Out of the actual positive classes, out of the TP plus FP, what is the meaning of TP plus FP? Out of all the predicted observations as positive, so system predicted that these all 500 are authentic users, but out of all those predicted positive users, actual positive users are 400. That is given by precision. So your system's precision in prediction is 80%. Okay, when it will be 100%, then all the actual users will be classified as positive. Okay, and no any wrong classification will be there. Same way, recall is TP divided by TP plus FN. So TP plus FN is the first row here, right? So what it represents? Actual positive. Actual positive means what? How many people are actually registered to the system? So there are 600 people registered to the system. Out of these 600 persons, 400 persons are classified as registered by the system, and 200 are not classified as registered. Okay, so system has incorrectly classified 200 people as non-registered, but they were actually registered, they were authentic. So 400 divided by 600 is the recall of the system, means what? How many percentage of users, authentic users, the system is able to identify? So this many percentage, right? So for a good system, for an ideal system, it should be able to have precision 100% and recall also 100%, right? In that case only our system is the perfect system. But there is no perfect system, so we should try to maximize precision and recall for each problem. So for this particular example, the precision is 80% and recall is 66.7%. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
So let me check how much it is clear. Let me give you one example. So there is another matrix, confusion matrix. Let me draw another confusion matrix. This is one system. For this system, calculate accuracy error, precision and recall. Everyone has to calculate these four values. Okay, start. For that, first of all, you have to calculate the total number of examples. So in this, how many examples are there total? Yes, but so 200 examples are there. Okay. It is 75 plus 15, 90 plus 45, 135 plus 60. So number of examples are 200. Now, what is the accuracy? Who will tell me?
70.
What?
70% accuracy, sir.
How it is 70%?
Sir, HGM predicted value and HGM negative predicted value.
Yes, so it is 75 plus 65, that is 140 divided by 200, right? 140 divided by 200, which gives us 70% accuracy. So error is 30%. What is the precision?
Sir, TP by TP plus FP.
So it is 75 divided by 90?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so it is around 83.3, right? So this is correct. And recall is this. 75 divided by 120.
63%. 63.
Everyone getting 63%? Okay.
So this is
about calculating accuracy, error, precision, and recall, right? So I think you have got the idea how to calculate this.
Yes, sir.
Now one more measure is there, which is known as F measure or F1 measure or F1 score. Okay, so this measure can be calculated with the help of precision and recall. So the formula is 2 into P into R divided by P plus R. Okay, so let's say for this case, what will be the F score? 2 into 80. So let us write in terms of this 0.8, 0.66 divided by P plus R. So what is 0.8 plus 0.66? 1.46. So find this value. So 2 into 0.8 into
0.66.
So are you getting 0.7232?
If we divide
0.72, so it is actually 72.32% in terms of percentage, right? So F score is 72.32 for this example. Same way, what will be the F score for this example? We have precision 83.3 and recall 63. It's 75 by 125. It will be 0.625. So if we keep it like this, what will be the F score for this example? F score is equal to 2 into 0.83 into 0.625 divided by 0.83 plus 0.625. 1.458. So 2 into 0.833 into 0.625 divided by 1.458. you are getting this value 71.41. This is the F score for this example. Okay. So these are three measures which are also used: precision, recall, and F score. Okay. So these are the evaluation measures for traditional classification system. Okay. But we are going to discuss now the evaluation measures used for information retrieval systems. Okay. So that also have the same kind of measures like precision, recall, but slightly some changes are there. So measures for IR systems. So what are the changes? It is also having precision and recall, right? But here what happens in classification system, we have at a time we have only one input. Okay, so let's say if it is digit recognition problem, what do you understand by digit recognition problem? One digit is given, we discussed this last time also.
See. Yes sir, we have to recognize the digit.
Right, so we have to recognize the digit like this, right? We discussed this last time that this is which digit, this is which digit, and so on. So the system should be able to understand that this is which digit. So for one digit, it makes some prediction. If it is correct, then it is correct classification. Otherwise, it is wrong classification. Okay. So that is classification system performance. But when we discuss about information retrieval systems, then what is the output in information retrieval systems?
Arun Doshi.
In search engines. Output is more than one web pages, right? So we have to check that whether the page is relevant to us or not. So here for each page, we will have to check whether the page is relevant or not, right? So in search engine system, what happens? Suppose you have given some query to the system and it will, let's say, give you 3000 web documents, right? So why the system gives you 3000 web documents? Because the system believes that you this 3000 pages are relevant to user need. So system thinks that these 3000 web pages will help user to search the expected documents. Okay, so these 3000 web pages are relevant according to the system. So they are relevant according to the system, but it is possible that the user does not find them relevant. Okay, user may find some web pages relevant, but all the web pages may not be found relevant. Okay, so out of these 3000 web pages, some web pages may be relevant to the user, some web pages will be irrelevant to the user, and depending on that we calculate the evaluation measures like precision and recall to find out that whether one page is relevant to user or not, second page is relevant to user or not. Okay, so because user will get all these web pages in some particular sequence, right? First response, second response. So at each sequence, at each rank position, we will have to check that what is the relevance of that particular web page. Okay. So for example, if I search something, let's say if I search natural language processing in Google. Okay, so you can see that it gives me lot of web pages, right? This is first web page, second web page, third web page. How many web pages it has given to me? it is mentioning here. Okay, so these many web pages it has given to me. How many? 78 crore 70 lakh web pages are given to me as the result, because the Google search engine thinks that all these 78 crore web pages are relevant to my query. Okay, so according to the search engine, these 78 crore pages are relevant to the user's query. But I will not go and check each of these 78 crore pages. Okay, I will only go through the first 2-3 pages. So it is possible that all the web pages are not relevant to the user, because if I go to some last page or something like that, then it is possible that I will get some different kind of web page which is not related to my interest. Okay, so these are called different rank position, right? This is first rank position, second rank position, third rank position, and so on. So for each rank position we will have to calculate precision and recall. So in machine learning or data mining, which we did this example, we calculate precision and recall for single only one time. But in IR system, search engine system, we have to calculate precision and recall for each rank position. So if we are given with 20 web pages, we will have to calculate 20 precision and recall values. If we are given 78 crore web pages, then we will have to calculate precision and recall 78 crore times. Okay, so likewise. So this is how it is done. So what is the procedure for performing this? So for that I will give you a link of a video. So first you watch that video, then we will discuss about the example. Okay, so I am posting that video in your link. So everyone watch that video. It is 10-15 minutes video which discusses how to calculate precision and recall at each rank position for an IR system performance evaluation. Okay, by pasting the link of that video in your chat box. So all of you watch that video, then we will discuss about it.